Hello everyone, welcome to Let's DevOps, myself Sumit, and today we are going to discuss about GitHub Action. GitHub Action is easy to learn and one of the best tools for DevOps implementation. I believe once you start using it, you will love it. So for all the discussion and demo, I will be following this article. You can find the link of this article under the video description. So now let's start with what is GitHub Action and how to use it, followed by demo. First of all, GitHub Action is open source, fully integrated with GitHub. It is one of the DevOps tool which we use it for setting up our CI/CD pipeline. In GitHub Action, workflow term is similar to the pipeline. And to use of the GitHub Action, you no need to do any additional configuration. So that is the beauty of it. So now we understood about what is GitHub Action and what is the use of it. Now let's talk about the architecture of GitHub Action. In GitHub Action, we create workflow, which gets triggered by event. Each workflow will have a list of jobs, and each jobs will have a list of steps. And this all configuration we write in YAML. So if you are new to YAML, I have another tutorial for beginners. You can find the link under the video description. Now let's talk about the components of GitHub Action. In GitHub Action, you can find the workflows, events, jobs, actions, and runners. In each workflow, you'll have this list of the components. Now let's talk about each component in detail. So first, workflow. So workflow is nothing but a pipeline. In GitHub Action, we call it as a workflow. So for creating any CI/CD configuration, you need to create a workflow, right? So all the action which we write in a workflow will be in YAML format only. And this is the very important note that all the YAML configuration file which you create, it must be under the GitHub workflow folder in your GitHub. So similar to this. So right now I have created some of the sample and we will see also in our demo. Now let's talk about the events. To trigger the workflow, we create a events. And if you see here, we have a multiple events. So these are the different kind of a type of the events on which your workflow will get triggered. So like on push or PR. So whenever there is a request of push or PR to your branches, the workflow will get triggered. It can be also scheduled one. It can be also a manual or it can also be parameterized. So these are different events that we can create which will help to trigger the workflow. Now let's see some of the YAML snippet which helps to trigger the event or create the event. So here if you see on push, if there is a push to the branch, dev branch, the workflow will get triggered. So if you add this particular configuration in workflow, on this event, the workflow will get triggered. Similarly, we have a parameterize. So for parameterize, we have a workflow dispatch. And these are the inputs. So once you provide the input and once you trigger that, it will trigger the workflow. Similarly, we have a GitHub schedule event and this is a manual. So we can see more in our demo. Coming to the jobs. So jobs is nothing but the collection of multiple steps and that we use it to achieve our CI/CD pipeline. So see here, you can have a multiple job and each job can run on multiple runners. So we'll discuss about the runner as well. So if you see here, job 1, I have defined multiple steps. For job 2, can I have a multiple steps, and job 3 also you can have a multiple. Each job basically runs on a specific machine and that we call it as a runner. Okay. Now let's talk about the action. So action is nothing but if you want to perform a specific task, you define under the action. So action can be built in also. You can see already a defined, predefined marketplace GitHub actions, Also, you can create your own customized action. And this basically helps to set up our CI/CD pipelines. So if you see here, these are the actions which is available in the GitHub Action Marketplace. And you can see there is a multiple categories, maybe for code quality, your code review, your deployment, your continuous integration, dependency management. For each, there is already a built-in action created, and that you can use it in our workflow. Okay, so basically action you can see here as well, like whenever you open your GitHub account, there will be action button. Under that you can see all of your workflow. So remember, in GitHub action we call it as a workflow, not the pipeline. Okay, so let's talk about the advantage of having the GitHub actions. So as I mentioned before, our action is used to perform any specific activity that you wanted to perform on the environment. If you want to set up a BDT like build, test, deploy, CI/CD activity, you can achieve through the action, and that can be available through the GitHub marketplace. With that, if you have some customized action that you created, you can maybe use it. You don't need to create extra modules or something. You just create your own action and then you put it in the marketplace and you can use it. So this is also helps to share that action. You can create your custom action and then maybe you can share with the different team also. And you can also post your action to the GitHub marketplace. If something you feel that can be used with a different company or different people that can use, they can also, you can share your action. Okay. So now let's talk about the runner. So in each workflow, as we know that workflow basically used for setting up our CI/CD pipeline, and for setting up the CI/CD pipeline we need to run some of the steps, and to run those steps we need some machine, right? That machine we call a runner. So for other DevOps tool we call it as an agent, but in GitHub action that we call it as a runner. So basically you can have first of all GitHub hosted and self-hosted. So you can create your own runner and configure, or maybe you can use your GitHub hosted runners. Okay, so if you see here, GitHub action basically have two types of runner. One is GitHub hosted, which is hosted by GitHub itself, and one is self-hosted. That one, like, you can create, you can manage it, and then we can use it in your GitHub action. Okay, let's talk about the workflow schema. So this is how the workflow looks like. So first of all, if you see, we are defining the name, right? So what is the name of the application workflow? So the name will be like application CI. We are setting up the continuous integration for application. Second is on. On is nothing but we are defining the event. Based on this event, this workflow will get triggered. So here what we have defined on push. If there is any push on this particular branch, this workflow will get triggered. The next we have a jobs. So as we know that jobs is nothing but the stuff or collection of steps that you run on a specific runner. So first of all, you define the job as a build, and then you are running that on a Windows latest. So this is nothing but you are defining your runner. And under the steps, you are defining all of your action, your custom actions, your marketplace section that you can define to achieve the CI/CD pipeline. Now let's start with the demo. So in this demo, what we will do, we'll first try to sign up for a GitHub account, and after sign up we'll create a repository that could be public or a private, and after that we'll create a sample workflow. So we will try to define the name, the event, jobs, and then the steps, and then we'll try to run the workflow. Okay, so let's start with that. So assume that if you do not have a GitHub account, it is free of cost. So basically you can sign up for free, and then you need to use this particular URL. So once you click that, you will get into this particular page. You need to put that your email detail, and then you need to continue. So once you are signed up, you will see this kind of a page. Okay, so I have just added my image and all. And once this is there, then you need to basically create a repository. So repository I have a multiple because I have already created. So you can basically create your first repository if you do not have, and under that you can basically give the name. So assume that if I want to give the name of LetsDevOps DevOps demo. Okay, and then this is a public or private. So basically, if you want to make it as a public, you can keep it as a public, and then if you want to make it as a private, you can have also private, so that nobody can see your code. And then you can create a repository. So I'll just make it as a public. Once you create it, it will ask you to initiate your repository in the sense of your branch, right? So just I'll add a readme file, and then I'll just commit it. Okay, so now let's talk a little bit about this particular URL and that component. So if you see here, we have a code section. Under that, you can define your application code, multiple branches, and then this is for tracking all of the issues, pull requests, and this is the action. Action is where basically we need to create a workflow, right? If I go here, right now we do not have any workflow. So let's create a sample workflow, right? So just I'll click on a setup a workflow for yourself. And if you see here, automatically this getting created, and these are the some YAML snippet which we have. So I'll just name it as a main.yaml, or maybe I'll call it as a demo YAML. Sorry, workflows and CI demo. Okay, so we'll try to go through the each component of this particular YAML file. Okay, I'll just commit it. So once I committed, this file will get created under the GitHub workflow. So I'll go to the action, and if you see here, I didn't do anything, but it's got automatically triggered. So now we'll see how it's got it got triggered automatically. So it is basically running, right? And it also got successful. So let's go to the workflow. So as I mentioned before, all the workflow should be gets created under the GitHub workflow, right? So now you can see here. So first of all, if you see, we have a name. This is nothing but your name of the workflow, and second is on is nothing but your event, right? And if you see here, we have a push or a pull request on the main branch. So since we just checked in the code, this automatically get triggered because we have this particular event, right? And then we have also workflow dispatch. Workflow dispatch is nothing but if you want to manually trigger, then you need to use it. Coming to the jobs, right? So jobs, here we define the jobs, and then you need to define the bill or whether you want to deploy, that you can define here. And this is very important, where we are defining on which runner it is running. So if it is Ubuntu hosted, it means that it is from the self-hosted. If you want it is a GitHub hosted. If you want your own self-hosted, basically you need to create a your machine, that I can create another video for that. And here if you see under this particular, we have a list of steps. So first step is from the action, which we are checking out the code, and then we are trying to run some of the sample command, right? Like hello world and all. So if we want to run this particular workflow, I need to go here, and then I need to go to the CI demo, and then run workflow, and just click on. So once I refresh it, it gets here, and then it gets triggered the workflow. So basically it will run it. And now see here, for this we didn't do any configuration at all, right? We just tried, we created one workflow, and then we started using it. Okay, so that is the beauty of the GitHub. Coming back to the checking the different actions which we have in marketplace, how you can check it. So basically if you come here, there is a marketplace and there is a documentation. So assume that if I want to do some build image, right? So just you need to search here, build ACR. So here see, right? These are the basically component. These are the already defined action that maybe you can use it, right? So you can basically search whatever you want. If you want to make some extensive search, you can always go to this particular tab, marketplace here. Just I'll try to open it. And based on the category, basically if you want to have for API management, code quality, code review, continuous deployment. These are the category you have under which the action is already created. You can basically make use of it and then you can set it up in your pipeline. Okay. So I think that's all from the demo. Okay, so let's go and check. Yeah, see here, our run got successful, and this is how you basically see your output. You can see your logs, what each step is basically doing. Okay. So now let's talk about some of the additional information. So if you see here, we have a GitHub secret, or one of the component in the GitHub, where basically you can store all the secret like GitHub token for all the API management. You wanted to have all the limitation, CLI management, everything you can do under the GitHub secrets. Secrets can also be a different type, like your organization level, repository level, and environment level. So secret to create your any value that is basically you wanted to keep it as a secret, you can create it here and then make use of it in your pipeline. So if you see here, we have a lot of options here to create a branch or create a branch policies. You have actions where you basically defining your runners. So here right now you do not have, but if you wanted to create your self-hosted runner, you can make use of it. If you want to include some webhook, you can just find it under the here and then you can create your own. And secret, basically to create your own secret. So assume that I wanted to create a secret for adding a service principle, right? So I'll say that, okay, dev sp, and here I can add it as, like, assume that if I time down number, so I can add it, and this is how it will get created. And this value you can basically use it in your pipeline. So basically you are not going to expose that value, whatever you feel that is a secret, or maybe certificate, any password, service principle secret, that you can define here, and then you can make use it in your pipeline, or sorry, we call it as a workflow, right? Okay, so I think that's all from the demo and about the GitHub action. So thanks for watching this video. If you like it, kindly subscribe it, and you can also add your feedback in the comment section so that I can improve. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.